Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I am doing this look. Now I know I said I wasn't going to do any more sparkle, but I came across this Revlon Photo Eye Art in Steel Spark, and I couldn't help it. I did it again. I'm sorry, I'm sure it's getting repetitive, the sparkle, but we might as well get all the sparkly shit out of the way right up front, right? Oh yeah, so we are going to set my timer so it helps me keep track of how long I've been fucking filming. And I'm going to show you guys one of my dogs real quick because yesterday's video I said I was going to do it and I forgot because they were being so quiet. So hold on. Come here, sweet girl. Oh, this is my sweet girl. And she needs a bath and she looks all crazy, but this is my cheetah girl. She's all scruffy and she's getting ready to go to the groomer. So maybe we'll do another picture of her when she's all cleaned up. But I let their fur stay long in the winter. And then once it starts getting nice, we trim them all up and make them cute again. But this is Cheetah. This is my little princess girl. Can you say hi? Say hi to mommy's friends? Yeah? A kiss? No? Oh, no kiss. My breasts stink? I love you. So this is one of my Yorkies. The other two are sleeping. There you go, baby girl. She's got to be right by my side, like all the time. Alright, well, let's get started because this might take a little bit. So I'm going to use my Huda palette to grab some colors from today. And I'm mainly going to be using sandalwood, henna, cocoa, and black truffle. So if you hear me referencing those colors, that's what they are. What else? Don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel. And this is day 7, baby. Don't forget to check out my friends Big Girl Beautiful and Morticia32. I'll link them in the description box below. And we're going in. I've already primed my eyes and done my foundation. I haven't set everything yet, but I've set my eyeshadow base. And I use MAC, you know, Soft Ochre Paint Pod, as usual. I just didn't think I needed to include it in the process because it, you know, same thing. So I wasn't even gonna do like all my contouring and blush today, but I was like, let's just get started and hopefully we'll get her done. And so I'm just starting with the sandalwood as my transition, and then I'm going to go into henna and put that right below. Now, a good trick to find out where a good place to lay the second color is to look up a little bit and find your natural socket and start working it around. This color is not even going to show up, but it will help when I use the cocoa color. Oh my god, excuse me. That was a big burp. I just drank a big old gulp of pop, sorry. Probably not smart to do before you put yourself on camera. And today is baseball day, so we've got baseball games starting in about an hour and a half. So, we're doing makeup. Somebody had suggested doing, you know, if I can't film one day to makeup, you know, do a few videos in one day. And I was really thinking about it. I was like, man, that's a really good idea. But I don't want to waste my makeup. It's expensive. And I don't know. I don't know what I'm going to do about that yet. I haven't decided. Okay, so you don't really have to build it up too much. Where's my other brush? So now I'm going to go in with cocoa, just cocoa, and lay that kind of right below that other color. And that will help get us to where we're at with that. So I just start lightly and then push in a little bit. So sometimes you may not see the color you're laying down in the final look, but it does help the darker colors to transition into. Woo! That's dark. That's dark. Oh boy. Well, I want it to be dark. And now I'm going to go into cocoa and black truffle and just set that right there. And I'm not going to do a lot because I am going to have to come back in and fix it all in a minute. So we're going to take a blending brush and just whip that around there all over the place and blend all that shit together. Especially the black needs to be blended. And that's the hardest one to do. So you have to kind of finesse it, I guess you'd call it. Call it finesse. And let's see. I think we could probably lay down this color and just start working around it. So I'm going to use the steel color from the Revlon. And it just looks like that. And just kind of wipe off the shit because there's a lot. And I'm going to start in my inner corner and bring it up. Now, I'm not bringing it up as high as I usually do. Just for reasons. Trying something different. Because I usually bring it up enough to see on my hood. But we're trying something different today. Why not? I'm into it. And now, once I lay that down, I kind of only have a very small amount of time before it starts drying. So I'm going to go in with a really dense pencil brush. It's very stiff. And I'm just going to help work that color around into that cocoa color. Now, we will have to touch this up when we're done. And re-put some, you know, put some more of that color down. But this helps to just blend out edges and stuff. Once you blend that out, when you put it back on, just don't go as high as what you just blended, basically. And now I'm going to go in with the cocoa color and the henna, which I know, weird, right? Just trust me, it all will make sense. It'll all look like the other eye if I just do it the same exact way. Hopefully. That's always the goal, right? Whoa, it's really dark. Can't get over how dark this is. It didn't start dark, I swear. It just didn't work the way I originally started with it. Oh, I just messed that up. Don't look at that eye. Don't look at that eye. I'm going to go in with henna and try to smooth all that out. Just henna. It's like a little dark. Don't want to lose the little bit of red undertone I have in the back, too. I think it helps the colors work well together. And this is not my favorite brush to use, but I just grabbed what I had that was clean. So now I'm going in with sandalwood, and I'm really just blending the shit out of all that stuff we put down. I'm trying to make them all work cohesively together, which, you know, girl, can be a struggle. It can be a struggle. It's a struggle. This was not a planned look. I just grabbed this thing and saw it and was like, ooh, sparkly. Ooh, gunmetal. Ooh, I love it. Now I'm going with this clean blending brush and I'm just going to go back and forth like that until you have something that looks like a big old mud pile. Then you know you're getting close. Then we're going to highlight again. Not highlight, but transition color. I'm bringing this one mostly up to my eyebrow bone. Is that right? Eyebrow bone? Yeah. Up to my brow. I'm bringing it really high up today. I'm just going for crazy bitch look. Okay, and now I have to go in with that cocoa and the black truffle again. And I'm going to start packing it on the outer corner into that color steel that we laid down. And we're just going to keep doing this until we get it to look pretty close to that one. Why are you trying me? I have one little spot where it won't go. I don't know why. That probably just... Oh my god, that's my second burp. Jesus, Sarah, come on. Ew. Yeah, sorry guys. It's part of being a human. You're gonna burp once in a while. Especially if you chug pop right before you start a video. And then we're gonna go back in with henna. Blend that out a little bit so it's not so crazy. And it's crazy. Never mind. It's just crazy. Oh well. Hopefully it'll look good when I'm all done. I don't hate my eye on this side. It looks okay. Just right there, I'm sure you can see where it's just being very spotty. It's like it won't stick on there. I don't know why. Probably because it fucking hates me. But this is what I do. I'm just going to go in with black. Pat it in there and not move it around. Oh, I did it. I'm gonna do the same thing over here. Oh, I did it. Haha. I win, you lose, fucker. I also want to take, I don't even want to say that after I just said fucker, but I want to take a minute to acknowledge the San Bernardino Elementary School that had a shooting today and 4 people were shot. And right now the news is saying that 2 people died. It hasn't said anything about the kids except for that they're in critical condition. I just want to take a moment and just acknowledge that that's the fucking world we live in, and it almost makes me want to start crying. My kid was in a school shooting his junior year. A kid came and shot a kid and then killed himself. He shot a teacher. My son would have been in that room that day, but he was in finals. Thank God he's got angels looking after him. But it's a sore subject for me when I see that on TV. I'm going to go in and put this. See it on the news. It just kills me. I don't understand what a kid could do to make you want to hurt them that bad. Now, authorities are saying that it was a domestic violence, something to do with the teacher. We'll not know for a while. I'm going to use a sparkly side on the side because I can't help it. It's a really weird sparkly color. And it's not predominant with this color. It's just, it gives it a little something. I'm ed up about it. I hate seeing it. It breaks my heart. So, I don't know. I just felt like I needed to say something because it really affected me when I saw it today. I literally started crying, and that's why my video was up so late. Because I started crying. It hurt to see. It hurt to see it happening. I hate seeing kids being evacuated from an elementary school. Like, what is going on with our world? And of course, America's getting ready to start World War III, and we're over in Syria where we have no freaking business, and we've got bigger problems going on here. And I don't know. I'm very political. I follow everything, and I usually won't talk about stuff like this on my channel, but today it really hit home and it scared me, and I felt like I needed to say something, especially for the kids that were hurt today and the people that lost their lives because of another human being's ability to cope. That's all it is. It's another person's inability to be able to cope with everyday problems, and they go and they take it out on innocent people that did nothing to them. Those little kids did nothing to him. Her, whoever it was, I don't even know the person, the shooter. I don't know if it was a girl or a boy. I imagine it was probably, you know, somebody. I don't want to say girl or boy because I don't know. We'll find out in the next couple days, but that just really affected me today, and it made me very sad. So I just want to take a moment and say something about it. Yeah. The day that happened to my son, they wouldn't let us go up to the school. They had, you know, about a 10-mile radius blocked off. And my kid stayed till the very end. They were getting kids evacuated on the buses, and they were meeting us down the street at a Fred Meyer's, and parents were told to go down there to get your kids. And it was about a 6-hour process, and my kid stayed all the way to the end to help other kids. He just didn't want to leave some of his friends behind, and him and another friend stayed till the end, and they were on the last bus home. So it was hard for me. Oh my God, I'm really fighting back tears. Shit. That's not what I wanted that to happen. I didn't want that to happen. I just wanted to take a minute and say something. So to anybody who's going through that, or if you were affected today, I'm sorry. I'm really sorry. Anyways, okay, back on to makeup. Seems so irrelevant in the world when shit like that's going on, huh? I am gonna just keep fucking this eye up until it matches this fucked up eye. No, I'm not. I'm just gonna quit while I'm ahead, maybe. I say that, and I have the hardest time doing it. I don't know. This was a little different. It's a little different colors. I don't know if I'm into it or not. I just thought it'd be fun to, play around with it. So why not? You only live once, right? I'm going heavy with that glitter, because I can't help it. So, you know, the other day when I was saying my soul's black and pink and glitter, I think it's that color right there, actually. All right, now I'm going to tight line real quick. I feel so weird just, like, talking about makeup after I talk about something so personal like that, but we must move along. The show must go on, right? It's just been on my mind all day, and I hate it. Oh, that does not even look the same. Oh, well. I'm going to a baseball game again today. Oh, I just dinked myself. And my wrinkle grabbed it and put it away. Thanks, wrinkle. Oh, wow, I should have brushed my eyelashes. I'm using my Benefit roller lash. And the eyeliner was the Tarte. If I switch up my eyeliner, I'll make sure to say what one I'm switching it up. If I don't, it's just because it's the same one. Oh, I've been really into the Tarte eyeliner paint, clay paint thing. That's what I've been using a lot of. Alright, this is why I love this mascara. It is the best. This is hands down the best mascara ever. And it lasts for freaking ever. I've had this for so long and it's still not dried out. Still going strong. Girl. Yes. Why do those look so different? I don't know. Maybe I need to blend this out a little bit. Oh. Blending's your friend. Nope, that didn't really make that big of a difference. Maybe we'll do it over here and see if it makes a difference over here. Nope, not really. And I'm fucking up my mascara by doing that, so hold on, I gotta fix that. It wouldn't be my video if it wasn't all over the place, right? You'd be watching someone else. And I wanted to say something about YouTube and all the drama going on, and I've tried to think of the words I was gonna say, but I still don't know. I wish y'all would not use YouTube as a way to just sit and bash each other. That's not what YouTube was for. That's not why it was created. That's not... It's a safe place to upload your videos where you're supposed to be embraced. You're supposed to be, you know, celebrated. Hey, you're doing something awesome, you know? And it just seems like it's not anymore. Just everybody's making videos about everybody else and always, you know, talking about each other and the hate and all that. It makes me sad. I'm a spread love, no hate kind of bitch. That's just how I am. I've had enough hate in my heart and I've had enough damage to know that I appreciate the happiness. I'm just trying to spend my life being happy. And I won't get involved. I won't talk shit about people. That's not what I'm into. Hence my name is Sarah Smiles on here. Because I'm not going to participate in the bashing of other people. I'm not really on anybody's side either. I mean, my girls are Miss Fucking Wonderful. You know, Big Girl Beautiful. I know Morticia 32. I like her and I know she's kind of been dealing with some of that. There's a lot of women on here I really like. But I'm not going to get involved. You know, it's not my fight. And until somebody personally comes after me, which you don't want to fucking do because I will light you the fuck up. Until someone comes after me, ooh, look at that flake in my hair. I'm going to stay out of it. It's not my fight. And I'm not into making drama videos, so I'm not talking shit. Those of you doing that, go ahead, do you, boo. You know, it just sucks because I don't think that's what YouTube was originally intended for. I'm pretty sure it was, you know, like to give yourself a safe place to go and upload your content without being, you know, harassed or bashed. And it just feels like that has all kind of, you know, subsided. And it's more about who's doing what with their money, who's doing what with their time. And I just, I don't know, it makes me feel bad. I'm just setting this with my Laura Mercier because I'm talking nonstop. This eye I know is darker. I'm probably gonna have to fix it off camera, but that's basically the look. We just went grungy again. Why not? I gotta get around my nose good because goddamn allergy season is killing me. Ugh. Yeah, I'm gonna use the rest of that and just put it somewhere. I hate wasting shit. And I'm gonna put this away, my Laura Mercier, and I'm gonna bust out. Why am I just holding this randomly? I'm gonna bust out my Tarte pressed powder and stick this all over my face. Same shit I've been doing. I am gonna get brave and start. Oh yeah, and I lost the fight with my eyebrows today, if you can't tell. One's janky and I just didn't feel like fighting with it anymore. So I let it win. So fuck it. You win. You win today. Where's my wonderful little brush at? Thank you. All right, I'm gonna go in with this little palette today, and I'm gonna use Chiseled. And this is a Tardius little mini pro glow to go thing. I'm just keeping it right there. I broke my other one yesterday, so I'm leaving it alone for a while. And we're just gonna pop some around, same thing, pop it around my hairline. Now Tarte has some of the, I think it's the clay, because this is the creamiest fucking shit I have ever worked with. I'll get other products and I guess naturally assume they're gonna be like this, and when they're not, I'm like, what the hell? And I realized that Tarte, duh, they use clay. They use Amazonian clay. And that, I don't know if that makes a big difference. I think it does. I'm gonna just do a little right there. Okay, and then I'm gonna go into this little palette I got that only has like four things in it. Three things, actually. Three little colors. And I'm gonna use the Abstract Blush. Let's see what this looks like. Oh, it's kind of dark. Oh, Tarte blushes are so good. Are you kidding me? Dude, I love this. Dark like my soul. I joke a lot about having a dark soul, but I'm actually a very nice, loving person. If I love you, you know I love you. And there's a few people I'd really love to stand up for here on YouTube that don't deserve some of the bullshit they're going through. And even that, I'm staying out of it. I'm just staying the fuck out of it. So now I'm going to go in with Gleam, which is very similar to the color Stunner in my big palette. Very similar. That one has a few more colored speckles in it, but that's kind of what I noticed with Tarte is a lot of their stuff is kind of similar. Some of the stuff. We are going to blend this out. I'm just putting this shit on here real quick. I'm not going to give myself a milk mustache, so now I'm going to go with this clean brush and just kind of blend around, especially up here. It's crazy. I'm actually going to take this powder brush that I just used and kind of soften those edges a little. The other day I was watching one of my videos and I could just see the line and I was like, oh my god, how embarrassing. I didn't blend my line good. And I don't need to make my forehead smaller. It's already pretty small. So let's go ahead and finish under the eyes, and then I think we're almost done. I'm basically using the same colors that I used going in on top. This is driving me absolutely crazy. Why are you fucking with me? Okay, see, I can go right back into it. I'm just gonna go in with henna underneath. Really doesn't show on camera how heavy I use, but I go pretty heavy with these lighter colors. Just because it helps me smoke out the darker stuff. And I connect it and bring it back around. I wonder how much time I have. 6 minutes? Oh, shit. Oh, shit. We talked a lot, didn't we? Well, I did. I'm going heavy with this shit today. Okay. And then we are going to take henna, which is that really unique orangey red color. Come on, girl. Get it under there. I still gotta put liner on the bottom and falsies. That's a lie. I don't put falsies on. we're gonna use Marc Jacobs to do the waterline because it was the closest thing in front of my face. And did I tight line? I don't even care if I tight lined. I'm just gonna get this done. Anything else I can fix off camera, I think. Oh, come on, lashes. Don't play me. You're the best formula. The heck did I do? Oh, I'm gonna have to fix those when I'm done. Okay. Let's do the mascara on the bottom. Well, this is the look. I mean, it looked like gunmetal to me, and now I got it on and I'm kind of like, I don't know if that's really gunmetal or not, but it's pretty. It's steel. It doesn't say it's gunmetal. It says it's actually steel. So that's okay. But yeah, my kid has a baseball game again 3 days a week, So that's what I'm doing after this, and yeah, just kind of doing a creepy little weird look today. I gotta come up with 30 different looks, so apparently a lot of them have had sparkle in them. I've noticed that too. I just got in a sparkly fucking mood. Okay, actually fix that real quick. Yay. Now we are going to line using the Wet n Wild color in Bear to Comet. This shit glides on so easy. Like, look at how easy that was. Fucking right. Okay, and then I am going to use the Nudie Patootie from Wet n Wild. It's just a plain nude color. Oh, there go my dogs. Sorry guys, they're gonna bark for a minute. Someone's coming to my house. It's probably my kid. My oldest kid. The other one's at the field getting ready. Cheetah, be quiet. I'm filming. Stop. I'm filming. So yeah, this is the look, and I think we're gonna set it real quick since we are leaving. And I'm gonna do my Max Fix Plus. Oh. Beautiful. Alright guys, well thanks for watching, and day number 7 done. Don't forget to go check out my friends. I'll link their descriptions in their links in the description box below, and I love you guys. Peace.